Your homepage is the digital storefront to your business, and optimizing it for SEO is crucial. Not only for making it look how you want it to look on the search engines, but also for your audience to get to know your business better. Tell me if this is familiar to you. You saw an ad maybe from Facebook and you purchased the product for a specific purpose. But when you search for the company, you realize that they provide a lot more products and services that you need. And that realization starts with the homepage. So in this video, let's break down the essential steps to make your homepage SEO and human friendly. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that brings you easy to use SEO and AI tools. And this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, it doesn't matter if your homepage is a static page that looks amazing or one that looks like a blog row. Either way, you will be able to optimize your homepage for SEO. So even if your site is running on Shopify, Framer, or whatever, this information is for you. So if you're ready, let's get started with the first optimization. Normally, when we think about optimizing the meta title of our homepage, particularly the most prominent feature on the search engine results, we would think about optimizing just the brand name, right? But check this out. If we search for an important keyword for RankMath, which is best free WordPress SEO tools, you will find us on the first page. And that's because we have optimized the meta title of our homepage with this. Now, that section after your brand name is normally meant for the slogan. So if you already have an established slogan, don't worry, you have the rest of the homepage to optimize for keywords. However, if the slogan is flexible, then we recommend that you brainstorm some keyword ideas you think will drive sales, get attention, or whatever the focus your website is. And then you want to validate if there are people searching for those keywords on keyword research tools like Google Keyword Planner, WordStream, Ahrefs, etc. And after that, pick the one that has the most search volume that aligns with your business. If you need a tutorial on keyword research, you can check out this video. And if you need free keyword research tools, you can check out this video. Links are in the description. Hope they help. Now, to optimize the meta title and description of your homepage, it depends if your homepage is a blog row or a specific page. You can hover over settings and check out the reading settings. If your homepage displays your latest posts, such as something like this, as a RankMath user, you can optimize the meta title and descriptions by visiting RankMath's titles and meta, click on homepage, and you can customize the homepage title as well as the description accordingly. For example, the brand of this site is Smoking Meats. This is the result of the site name variable, and you want to add a separator that looks like this, and the slogan will be the ultimate BBQ experience. I will explain where RankMath gets this information in a while, but for now, you can optimize your meta description as well. For example, elevate your outdoor cooking with smoking meats. You see, once again, we optimize our brand name in the meta description, and we have included an important keyword, outdoor cooking. And then check out our top rated BBQ grills, which is another important keyword. Ideal for smoking, grilling, and searing. You see, we have included many relevant keywords in the meta description, and the key is to be natural. Do not stuff keywords in the meta description. And most importantly, the description should thoroughly explain what your company is about and what it offers. Anyway, these variables are taking information from your site settings. Under Settings and General, these are the information added to the meta title. Now, if instead you have assigned a page as your homepage, under the reading settings, let's say that I've created a page called homepage and I've assigned it as the homepage, and let's save changes. In that case, you will need to customize the meta title and description directly from the assigned page. As you visit the list of pages on your site, you can find the assigned homepage here. Click on Edit, go to the RankMath tab, click on Edit Snippet, and from here you can edit the meta title and description accordingly. Similarly, I would add the site title variable, have a separator, and add the site description. And as for the meta description, I would add the same. As you close this and save changes, your meta title and description will now be optimized. If you're not sure what keywords to focus on for your homepage, simply leverage on your biggest competitor. For example, if RankMath is your biggest competitor, simply copy their homepage URL, and then you want to search for RankMath SEO Analyzer, and visit this tool. It is a free tool to use. We have left a link to this page in the description as well. And then you want to pop the URL in this field and click Analyze. In a few seconds, you will get a report. And right here, the common keywords. These are the keywords you should focus on optimizing for your homepage to beat your competitor. Give the tool a try. I'm pretty sure you'll find it useful. Now, this is the most basic SEO principle any website owners need to follow. It doesn't matter if you're writing a blog, creating service pages, or optimizing your homepage, proper heading hierarchy needs to be followed. Every page on your website, including your homepage, can only have one H1 heading tag. On WordPress, the page title will be H1, so you don't want to leave it as homepage. You want to optimize it the same way it appears in the meta title. And then any titles you add after that should be H2s. Now, H2s will allow readers or site visitors to understand the hierarchy of the page, but they help expand the main topic, which is H1. And if you want to further describe a H2 heading and separate your content into sections, you would use H3, such as something like this. So if you want to see the overall hierarchy of your homepage, bring your mouse over to this document overview, click on it, select outline, it will show you the hierarchy of your page. As I've shown you earlier, H2s will explain the H1, which is the title of your page, and then these H3 heading tags will further explain this H2 heading. Never use a H3 without a H2, or have a H4 without a H3. You have to follow the hierarchy. For example, this looks like a nice place to add a heading, and if I put this as H6, in the outline, it will show you that there is an incorrect heading level. So you have to respect the heading hierarchy. Now again, if you don't know what H2 heading tags to use for your business, do you remember we used RankMath's SEO analyzer earlier on your biggest competitor? There is this section called H2 headings, where it will tell you what headings your competitors has used. And from here, you can have a better idea on what heading you should optimize for your business. Now, having a brandable logo on your homepage as well as the favicon is a no-brainer. It is a must-have if you want your business to stand out. For example, would you want your customers to search for your site and find this? It is unprofessional, right? And it is screaming, "Do not trust this business, it is sketchy." Or if someone visits the homepage and the logo is just a text link, it shows no effort in branding and differentiation. And what does that say about your business? I can only think about the negative things. Nowadays, it is so easy to get a nice looking logo for your business. Simply search for the keyword AI logo designer and you will find some tools and services that will get the job done. And once you have a nice looking logo, here's where you will place them. Now, every WordPress theme works differently. But for most themes, you can visit the theme customizer by hovering over Appearance and select Customize. And in the theme editor, you will need to find something called site identity. And from here, you can add the favicon so that your logo will appear on both the browser tab and on the search results. And then you will also want to add your logo in the header. For the currently installed theme, it will be in the header. I'll click on the logo and add the site logo here. Now, your favicon can be different from the logo you add here, but it is really up to you. I'll adjust the size and save changes. Now, one more place to add your site logo, and it is on RankMath. Because if your site logo were to appear anywhere on a search results page, it would look like this. Anyway, back to the site, let's head over to RankMath's dashboard. If you have not gone through the setup wizard, we highly recommend that you do so because one of the steps would ask for your site logo. But if you have gone through that and you want to change the site logo, then visit the titles that matter, and under local SEO, scroll down a little, and you will see the logo section, where it recommends having a squared image with a minimum dimension of 112 pixels on each side. It will be really tempting to add as many internal links from your homepage to every page of your website to spread out the link equity. There is a high chance that your homepage will have the most backlinks. Now, if your site is small, there is no issue. But what if your site has hundreds or thousands of pages? It just doesn't make sense to add all the links on your homepage. So don't overload your homepage, header menu, or footer with too many links. Keep them focused on what you want your audience to do. If your site offers one or two products or services, much like RankMath, you would keep it focused on your offerings. We offer an SEO plugin. We have an integrated AI tool called Content AI. We show the pricing for both the products. We offer free tools as well. Here's where you will get support. And this is for existing customers to log into their account. All these are internal links, which means that they link back to a page on the same website. You see, all these make sense, right? The key is to understand the needs and wants of your new and existing customers. Now, at the top of the page, which is the hero section, you will have a clear call to action to tell your new site visitors what to do. For us, you can download RankMap plugin for free. You can try the demo here. What to add here depends on the focus of your business. What is the main thing you want your site visitors to do? And then as you scroll through the page, you don't want to cram as much information onto the page, only the important ones. For example, RankMap has many different features, but we do not add all of them here. We place a link to another page that lists the full features. And as you scroll down further, we share with you some important features. And right here, notice this call to action button. This links to the same page that lists all the features. Take note of this link at the bottom left. As I hover over the call to action button, you can see that it links to the same page. So the links on this homepage are very focused. It leads the visitors to one focus page. And as you scroll down further, if a site visitor decides to get RankMath Pro, they can check out the pricing page. If not, they can download the free version of the plugin. And then at the footer, this is where you will place internal links to other important pages of your site, like your recommended links, your important guides on how your product works, links to your company's pages, about your brands, and other pages your site visitors may find useful. Social proof can be in the form of reviews from satisfied customers, it can be icons from clients or companies you have worked with, it can be customer reviews from third-party sites like Trustpilot, media mentions, industry awards or certificates, and influencer endorsements. And having these social proofs on your homepage can positively contribute to the experience, expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness, EEAT, which are crucial components to Google Search Quality Guidelines. So if you have the slightest form of endorsement from your customers or some authority figure in your niche, you want to add them to your homepage. Now, just a hint. If your business or site is new, whenever you have a customer, ask them to leave a review for your business. And if you want to ease their troubles of coming up with a review, use this. On RankMath's dashboard, make sure that the Content AI module is toggled on, and then you want to visit the Content AI module. Search for testimonial, and you will find a tool here. Click on it. Now add the name of your product or service. Ask what your customer likes about your product or service, and you can help them fill this up. If your customers have any negative things to say about your product, you can add them here to have a balanced view. Add a focus keyword if you have any. Select an appropriate audience. Add a tone. This depends on your customer's tone of voice. Select a length. The short option will generate 1 to 2 sentences. The medium option will generate 3 to 4 sentences. And the long option will generate more than 5 sentences. Now select a language. There are over 28 languages and more will be added. Select the number of outputs. And hit generate. In a few seconds, show this to your customer and ask for approval to use it. Just like any blog post or pages, it will be plain boring if it is just text. So try to include images or even videos whenever possible, like describing the features of your product or service, giving a demonstration of your product, explaining what your business is about. And it is always nice to have images of people who left a testimonial for your business. And the thing is, whenever you add an image on your page, you want to make sure to visit the image settings and add an alternative text, or in short, the alt text for your image. This is to describe what your image is about. This not only enhances the browsing experience of the visually impaired, but also for people who do not have proper internet connection. And if you need help describing the image, you can always rely on Content AI to write it for you. Simply click on Generate Alt, and a description will be generated for you. Now, user experience is a very broad topic. It can be improving your site speed, reducing intrusive marketing and animations. It can be mobile optimization, better navigation, etc. So we will tackle them one at a time, starting with mobile optimization. Nowadays, everyone visits a website with their mobile phones. So if your website is not mobile optimized, there is a high likelihood that people will leave your site immediately without checking its content. So to check if your homepage is mobile friendly, feel free to visit this page. This is the link. We have left the same in the description. Now simply copy and paste your homepage URL here and click on Analyze. And in a while, you will know if your site is mobile friendly or not. There is no excuse not to have a mobile friendly website these days because there are vast tools like modern WordPress themes that are mobile friendly by default. But anyway, talking about intrusive marketing. I don't know about you, but I personally dislike sites that use pop-ups like this that hijack your attention. It used to work, but it is getting annoying nowadays. And what about sites that place almost 30% of the screen with advertisements, especially on their homepage? I would like to hear your opinion on this. Do you personally like these types of marketing in this day and age? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, as we are moving towards the future, we will see more and more sites having clean animations and motion graphics, like WP Rocket. As you can see, these animations clearly help with communicating its product offerings. And sites like Dropbox that gives a wow factor and communicates their features with every scroll. So animations, when used properly, can elevate the user experience. Now, if your site is built for the purpose of allowing people to search for something, such as a site like Property Guru, where people need to find available house to buy or rent, then it will make sense to add a search function to your homepage. Or if your site is like Amazon where you sell lots of different products, it will make sense to have a search bar as well. With it, people can find what they need quicker and this will help improve the user experience. And finally, when talking about improving site speed, it is a big topic on its own and we have provided quite a few unique tips to help you out. Feel free to check out this video right here. The link is in the description. So these are the homepage SEO you should implement. And of course, after the implementation, you should run your homepage through RankMath's SEO analyzer and it will provide you with more optimization tips to make sure that your homepage is well optimized for SEO. Oh, and some additional tips. Try to build backlinks to your homepage as this will help improve the site's EEAT. If you need help building backlinks, check out this video right here. And if you have troubles writing your homepage copy, chat with our rank bot under the Content AI module and it will be able to write them for you. You should target to have at least 400 words worth of quality content on your homepage to describe what your website or business is about. Anyway, if you find this video helpful, how about helping us out by smashing that thumbs up? And if you haven't subscribed to us, do so because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.